It happened several times last year when I was in Nepal. I had gone as part of a commissioned work to see the effects of the earthquake there. There was an earthquake last year. It was pretty bad. One of the days we walked into this town called Shanku that was close to the epicenter of the quake, and that was one of the worst hit towns in Nepal. And when I walked in, I'm like, okay, is this like a Hollywood movie set? Because a city is not supposed to look like this. There are these moments for artists which are not really moments where you make art with, but these are supplementary moments which influence you to do something later. In the same town, we went to the families who had lost their houses. So we entered there, and there's this family who welcomed us, and they had nothing. They had absolutely nothing. So, you know, the pastor who was there, and you know, he took out a bottle of Coke from under the couch, literally. They don't have electricity, and you know, it's just a bottle of Coke, and he opens it and he shares it with us. And all they had was ramen noodles, you know. And in the Indian culture and the Nepalese culture, it's an act of respect and honor to give food to your guests. And when I saw what they were doing out of their love and respect, in spite of not having anything, literally what they had was just ramen noodles, that's it. And we shared a meal together. I mean, I took a picture on my phone, but each time I see the plate of ramen noodles and Coke, which was served in a cup, you know, I was like, okay, that's something which transcends. I mean, that's the reason why I'm there, not actually to take pictures, you know, to experience the love and kindness that people have. So often I feel like when you ask about a moment, it may not be a moment where I actually take a picture, but it's all these supporting moments which eventually lead to my art and development as an artist.